In this figure, we'll examine oral immunity. And oral immunity is immunity mediated by a secreted form of antibody, the S-IgA antibody. And this is a little bit different than a lot of other antibodies like IgG, which is a circulating antibody. This is an antibody that gets secreted across a mucosal membrane, the lining of the GI tract, specifically in this case. And it has to function a little bit differently because it's not actually functioning inside the body. IgG, the main circulating antibody type, actually functions by activating complement and other immune system components. Well, those are not found in the gut lumen in major quantities, and therefore the major mechanism of secretory IgA function is by blocking or neutralizing pathogenic bacteria and toxins in the food we eat from binding receptors and being taken up across the enterocyte lining, that mucous membrane. So it's sort of like blocking their ability to actually enter the body and create a bigger problem. And so we have our bacteria here in the gut. Again, there are multiple mechanisms of keeping these bacterial populations in check. But one of them is going to be by endocytosing these bacteria and food antigens that occurs in M cells that we saw in a previous figure. And those M cells provide these antigens to the underlying dendritic cells and macrophages, which are antigen-presenting cells. Again, we saw this previously, and those antigen-presenting cells present those antigens using the MHC proteins to the B and T lymphocytes in the underlying MALT, the mucosa-associated lymphatic tissue. In the ileum, it was called Peyer's patches. And so these naive B cells become activated, right, by exposure, the antigen presentation by the dendritic cells or the macrophages, which we're not showing you here. We get maturation of those cells and clonal expansion and the production of many, many plasma cells that produce this IgA, this secretory IgA antibody. And it is dimeric, meaning it's actually two antibody structures sort of linked together, shown here. And there are receptors for that on the basolateral membranes of these enterocytes that initiate endocytosis. We now have a vesicle containing those antibodies. And then they're exocytosed at the apical membrane into the lumen of the gut. And those secretory IgA antibodies get attached to the mucus. So they form this sort of barrier in the mucus layer, preventing the proliferation of those bacteria. They sort of bind them up. They also prevent them from crossing by binding them and neutralizing their activities. And then, of course, there is a free component as well that's acting out here to bind those free foreign antigens, those bacteria, and again, limit their ability to infect this mucosal membrane. And again, we're blocking the ability of these pathogenic bacteria and other toxins from entering, but at certain sites we have to have access, where the M cells are found, access of those antigens to help initiate the activation of these naive lymphocytes, the B and T cells. And again, it's the B cells that are going to lead to the antibody production, and then these secretory IgA is going to be produced and released at these mucous membranes, helping to fight the infection where the infection occurs. This is important because it's not a circulating antibody. It's not creating a systemic immune response. It's creating a very focal one where the potential infection might be occurring, and therefore keeping those bacteria in check in the lumen of this gut.